Yoshi's Crafted World is the kind of game that restores your faith in humanity. Well, that and bring balance back to your frayed and frazzled mind after hours of playing Sekiro Shadows Die Twice. Spoiler alert, I died more than twice while playing Sekiro. Or thrice. Or thrice. Or four times. Ooh, what's that light on yonder side? And should I walk toward it? Grandfather, is that you? Seriously though, as someone who works in journalism and gets exposed to a plethora of bad and even badder news, or worse news for you English majors, yeah, as someone who gets exposed to a lot of that on a daily basis from across the globe, not to mention the negative Facebook news comments, it's nice to occasionally enjoy something that reminds you that there's still a lot of good in this world. You know, that everything is gonna be okay. At least that's the sense I get when playing Yoshi's Crafted World for the Nintendo Switch. Talk about a sugary sweet delight. It's like a ray of sunshine surrounded by double rainbows and flowers wrapped in colorful paper craft. It's also the type of game that some self-professed quote-unquote hardcore gamers decry as kiddie Nintendo fluff. Never mind that it's probably the kind of fluff that they used to love when they were kids too. And just wait till they have children of their own. That's when a lot of people actually rediscover religion, so to speak, or see the light and realize there is a place for games that they could play with their kids. Basically, just because a game is geared toward children and families does not mean it's a bad game for filthy casuals that's ruining the industry. It's just a game that's, you know, geared toward children and families. That's all it is. I mean, heaven help us all if retail stores only sold checkered shirts and skinny jeans for folks aged 13 to 30. But I digress. Yoshi's Crafted World is the exact kind of game in Nintendo's proverbial wheelhouse. Where's that treehouse? Like many Yoshi games before it, you've got a gaggle of cute Yoshi dinosaurs chilling together in peace until professional peace wrecker Kamek swoops in to ruin everything. Riding shotgun with the broom-riding Koopa Wizard is none other than the mischievous Baby Bowser. Not to be confused with Bowser Jr. Yeah, just in case you didn't know, Baby Bowser is actually the baby version of Bowser in the past, or something like that. Anyway, Bowser hatches a plan with Kamek to steal the Yoshi's Prize Gem Set Stone. The Yoshis then embark on an adventure to regain the lost pieces of their precious stone, leading to the meat of Yoshi's Crafted World. Admittedly, the narrative ain't God of War or The Liar Princess and the Blind Prince. As far as Nintendo games go, this story is less Legend of Zelda and more classic Super Mario Bros., where you have a simple and whimsical tale serving as a quick setup to the gameplay. That being said, it still has its share of hilarious moments, most of which involve interactions with the future Koopa King, his spikiness. The simpler narrative also doesn't detract from the things that the game does well, which are mainly its unique colorful presentation and, of course, traditional Yoshi-style platforming. Like Yoshi's Woolly World before it, Yoshi's Crafted World uses distinct materials to craft its unique look. Pun so totally intended. This time it's crafts and everyday objects, so cardboard, cups, boxes, cloth, you know, that kind of stuff. The result is a fun and warm aesthetic on top of the Yoshi series' trademark charm. Certain scenes also have a stop-motion quality to them, adding even more of a kids' show vibe to the process. I personally think that the developers did a great job in designing the stages and their various gimmicks to fully leverage the crafted aesthetic. While Woolly World uses a lot of yarn spooling or unspooling effects, for example, Yoshi's Crafted World has a lot of flipping and toppling gimmicks that reveal hidden areas and objects, just to name a few. Stages are also designed to be experienced, not just on one side, but with reverse paths that allow you to literally experience them on the flip side. One plus for families is the ability to play the game in co-op by handing a second controller or Joy-Con to your partner. Speaking of controls, I'd also just like to say thank you to whoever's responsible for enabling pro controller support for this game. As the cool kids say in texts or online comments these days, you're the real MVP. Gameplay will be familiar to veterans of Yoshi games. Eggs serve as your primary weapon once more, and you can stock up on them by either gobbling foes or smacking egg boxes. You can then use these eggs to hit enemies, items, structures, flowers, and all sorts of other stuff. And I definitely encourage you to just aim the cursor at whatever catches your fancy. Interaction is a key focus in the game, and Yoshi's Crafted World encourages you to use those eggs to uncover what its various settings have to offer. It also likes to play up creativity, including crafting solutions like a makeshift train whose parts you have to find, for example. It basically imbues a childlike sense of wonder within its world, which is especially great for younger players. The game's family friendliness is also reflected in the difficulty, which, like Kirby games, isn't all that hard. Like other games before it, Yoshi's Crafted World is very forgiving, especially with the addition of new costumes that help you absorb even more punishment. These costumes, which just look adorable, can typically be acquired by using coins that you earn in stages to feed a gacha, gachapon, or prize machine with random goodies. Thankfully, these don't require real money and rely solely on in-game currency, you know, just like how old games used to be. Imagine that. For folks looking for a challenge, the main source for that would be finishing each stage with complete marks, including a full set of hearts, while making sure you find every hidden secret in each stage, including all the flower symbols. By adding that to your to-do list, you get a bit more engagement in your adventure and might even have to repeat stages a few times if you miss them during your first playthrough. Since these are optional though, it also means that kids don't have to get frustrated about getting stuck because they can still finish stages without finding all the secrets. Bosses meanwhile are a reflection of the game's charming aesthetic and require some creative approaches that aren't limited to egg throwing. These bosses typically reflect Nintendo's classic mechanic of requiring 3 solid hits on a weak point to take them down once you figure out their different patterns or phases. They also include a bunch of cookie misfits with hilarious designs, from a pirate octopus that chucks balls, a conjurer with a tin can as a body, and a giant inflatable beach ball named Bert the Ball. I'm sorry. Whose weak point is a makeshift band-aid on his butt where his air valve is located. You can't make this stuff up. I'm being serious here. Anyway, this is the kind of goofiness that makes Yoshi's Crafted World a treat to play, especially around younger kids. Granted, the game does lean a bit on the easy side, maybe too easy for a lot of folks. The base gameplay also doesn't quite advance the series, nor does it add anything that's much different from the familiar Yoshi formula that we've seen over the years. But, and I'm not talking about Bert the Ball's butt, but its level of polish and oodles of charm give Yoshi's Crafted World a lot of heart. It's the kind of game that you can enjoy with your kids, younger cousins, nephews, nieces, or even fellow adults who still remember what it's like to be a child. As someone who has always liked kiddie games like this, there are definitely times when it's okay not to grow up. Anyway, those are my thoughts about Yoshi's Crafted World. So what do you think about the game? As always, feel free to leave any thoughts or questions in the comment section. Once again, this is Tabi Asobi, and thank you for watching.